Hey everybody, this is CJ and I hope your day is just going glorious. I am ecstatic to be with you today because we're going to dive into some material that again goes into relationship with others. And before we really get into it, I want you just to think about how you see yourself. A lot of people see themselves through the lenses of how others see them or how they may see themselves or perceive themselves based on things. And we want to talk about identity today. Identity. Because a lot of people have identity that may be a false identity based on how they see themselves and not based on how God sees you. See, the Bible says, it is Christ that lives in me and it is no longer me. So today we're going to focus on really identity in Christ. Identity in Christ. And the reason why is because the world is full of so-called, so many different diverse identities. They want us to be seen in a certain light. We gotta look a certain way. We gotta weigh so much. We gotta be so much of a certain height. We gotta have so much money. We gotta do so many things. We gotta graduate with this degree. We gotta be a certain kind of a person. But to Jesus, you are already a certain kind of a person because he made you that way. And so there has to be an acceptance of who you are based on the identity that you have in Christ. So what I want to do is I want to first go to the scriptures, and we're going to be in Matthew 7, and we're going to begin reading in verse 24, where Jesus himself is actually quoting here and stating, I should say, "Therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his house on the rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock." This first piece that we want to talk about in identity is stability. Stability deals with foundation. Your foundation is your grounding. It is what you are building your life on. Notice that in this scripture, the Bible highlights that this person that Jesus is referring to, he was a wise man. So you have to understand, wisdom builds foundations. Without wisdom, which is really the inside of God, you will never know you unless you really know God. Let me share that again. You will never find you unless you find God. And a lot of people are trying to find themselves outside of the maker and the creator of you. How is that going to be possible? You can't tell something that's been created how to follow that which it needs to unless it follows the creator. And so Jesus says that this person is like a wise man because he listens to the sayings that he gives. In other words, he's following the instructions. So stability and foundations are typically built because of following instructions. Think about a house. Think about a home. Any home is first off going to have a foundation. Can't build anything up unless you make sure it's going to be grounded before you build. And a lot of us, whether we want to admit it or not, we're trying to accomplish a lot of things in life. We want a lot of things to happen and to flow and to transpire and to manifest. But what about the foundation you're putting all that on? Because if the foundation is not strong, then everything you put on this so-called life of yours is virtually at the disposal of falling over. It can fall over. It can actually collapse because of the foundation. The foundation is the core of any structure, of any building, of any body that is trying to become anything. You must assess the foundation. And foundation still, it deals with your stability. Now understand, in the word stability is the word ability. Your stability comes from his ability. Come on, somebody. If you really want to know if you have power, you need to see yourself functioning in his power, not yours. But knowing it's by his grace you are sufficient. Though I am weak, he is strong. This is how we function in stability. And a lot of us, when we go through struggles and we go through tension, we're going to find out what kind of foundation we have really built in the core of us. Who we really are will always show up when you really go through something. Amen. What you really face in life will tell the truth about your so-called life. Amen. So first, stability. And now I want us to go over to the book of Psalms. We're in Psalm 16 and verse 8. And the Bible says in verse 8, I have set the Lord always before me. Listen, I have set the Lord always before me. So this is a selfless move. Security means that it is outside of your jurisdiction. I have a security system on my home. And the thing is, I don't know exactly how it works, but I believe that once I push in the code to put security in my home, it gives me comfort. It gives me peace. It gives me something that is in the realm of security, because I know that virtually it is going to protect me. This is what security is all about. It is about the protection of God, the strength of God, the might of God that is outside of you. It is God using you and showing you his power in your life, through your life, whatever you face that may come up in your life. He is there doing that. The rest of the text says, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Listen, because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Do you realize that right hand, when you look at it in the Bible, right hand means authority? So in other words, because God has all authority, I shall not be moved. But in order for that to happen, I have to give him all authority. I have to surrender him to have all authority in my life. That is not going to happen unless I'm willing for that to take place. He has to have the ability to be able to move inside of me because I've surrendered my life for him to have full authority over my life. Wow. That means that even those times when I'm struggling and I'm dealing with things that seem virtually like, is this my will or God's will? We are dealing with things that deal with security. Because security is in the will of the Lord. Security is in the authority of God. Security is in God's hand because the Bible just read to us, he has given us the ability to be by his hand, which we shall not move from. In other words, we trust in his authority, like I trust in my alarm system. The third thing that we want to look at is from the book of Philippians, and we're going to go to Philippians 4. Philippians 4 and verse 19. And the Bible says here in verse 19, and my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. My God shall supply all your need. Just want you to think about that. Just fathom that for a moment. That God has the ability to supply. In other words, there is a constant flow that is going to materialize in your life to constantly make sure that your needs are being met, which takes us to significance. So we've talked about stability, we've talked about security, now we're talking about significance, which is dealing with the intent of a thing, and that the way that you are, who you are. I want you to understand that who you are is somebody that God is going to make sure you're going to have all your needs met in order to address who you truly are. You are made in the image of God. You are called a child of God. You are a child of the Most High. You are an ambassador. An ambassador is a representative. When you are a representative, guess what? You stand out. God wants all of us who are in Christ to be at a place where we recognize we are significant. No one should feel in Christ like they're insignificant. They have no role. They have no place to play out what God had envisioned for that individual in life. I pray today that God will reveal to you the importance of making sure that you know your identity in Christ. May you be blessed today, and may you always remember you were born to be a blessing.